Okay, the second half of the Arbiter's grounds. Starting it off beautifully with a beautiful jump attack, followed by the most overkill, slamming it straight into that man's skull. Man, Ganondorf even fell that one, back in a different game even. Anyway, so yeah, this is interesting, because the big key, as you can see, is right there, just completely taunting us. And again, using Wolfling's jumping ability, I believe you can actually just straight up get across this pit and grab the key. Not that it, sorry, not that it would actually be of use to us, because, you know, we need the dungeon item still that would be handy to grab, so that's actually what we're going to be doing next. This doesn't look like an ominous room at all. Geronimo! That works. Overkill? No, Link, you missed. He's getting away so slowly. As if Link made that jump. Holy crap, you're insane, Link. Okay, let's pull back on this and raise a couple floors just so we can grab grab this chest over here. And my OCD needs that blue rupee. There we go. I got him through there. Oh my god. Sweet, a small key. That'll be useful. When has a small key never not been useful in a Zelda game? Seriously. And, let's just keep raising. Get away from me. Die! Okay. Let's actually raise the roof. Link, please. There we go. And, just keep going up until we can't no more. That's not anything. No. This was nothing! What's the point? This is not anything either. My god, this place goes high. I'm assuming this is the entrance. Yes, it is, because the red dot's right there. Okay, good to know. Okay, now we can actually push all the way to the bottom. Riveting gameplay, I know. There we go. Okay. And now with that small key that we grabbed, we can actually just head right through here. Oh, this room looks lovely. This looks like kind of like a room where like saw blades would like come at you from the very front of the room all the way down or something. Also, I find it strange. There we go. I was just gonna say, I find it strange how we haven't, how none of these are actually popping up with any spikes or anything. Oh god, they can actually pop up in the sand. That's not good. Okay, well, we can't go that way then. Oh, that's not good. Rats! Okay, and again, using our Wolfling powers, we can actually get across the sand quite easily. Especially since we pretty much need Wolfling for this room, just so we can get rid of these rats. And we can also get rid of this, too. As Minna freaks out. Poor Minna. Okay. No, Wolflink. Oh god, that was close. Wow, I just realized, you can't even get rid of them, even if, like, you use a spin attack or anything. You need to be using sense to be even be able to attack them. That's actually kind of crazy. Okay, let's get across here and get deeper in. Oh god, there's bugs everywhere. Now this is just becoming just an episode of Fear Factor or something. Oh my god, Uku is here? Are you serious? What is with this? I think the game designers mixed up where to put the compass and where to put Uku, because this Uku should have been where the compass was. Also, I like how we're just having this casual conversation as an army of beetles is right there. Whoa, that was weird. Their texture just freaked the hell out. Get away from me. Oh god, this isn't making this dungeon any better, game. Anyway, now with Uku, we can actually use her to exit the dungeon if we had any use of it again. I probably won't be doing so because it just seems pointless, because I'd have to backtrack so much just to grab some red potion. It just doesn't seem worth it, so I'll just man it out and do the best I can with what hearts I have, which I know isn't very much, but you gotta do what you gotta do. You seriously just use two bomb arrows on them? You don't even have to use your sword. You just use bomb arrows and then they're dead. Okay, that's hands down the worst Stealthos in the whole series then. Can you destroy them before they've spawned? Okay, at least they have to spawn. Ow. Poor Link. He's taken so many explosions to the face in this dungeon. There we go. Not looking good on the heart department, though. Heart department, that's actually kind of funny. In fact, where am I even going now that I think about it? Because I can't even get up here, can I? That's a good question, actually. Where am I even going right now? Can I, like, use sense at all or anything? We don't have any small keys. What's the minimap show us? Where am I even going? Okay, so according to our minimap, it really looks like we should be getting over there. Which just begs the question, how? There's no way we're supposed to get across this pit right now. So where do we even go? There's nothing to claw shot. Oh my god, I just noticed this. Okay, here we go. This is where we go. There we go. Okay, I thought I was going crazy for a second. Okay, now Wolfling bonks on the stairs? What is going on in this game? Ugh. Get away from me, Beetle. Oh, thank god. Okay, so normally I wouldn't be scared. Oh my god, what the hell is that? I'm feeling terrified right now. Also the fact that I only have 4 hearts. Maybe that was a bad idea. Uh-oh. Well, crap. Okay, so you'd think you'd want to go sword on sword with this thing, but as you can see, you actually do need to use your abilities to see him, because he is a ghost wielding a giant sword, and shout out to this guy, because in as far as the... I'm gonna die, aren't I? I'm gonna fucking die, aren't I? As far as cool boss designs go, this guy definitely takes the cake for the coolest mini boss in the whole game. This guy looks cool enough to be a normal boss that you fight, let alone a mini boss. So, a really cool design for this guy. Oh, the smoke effect's actually really cool. Bring it on. Oh god. Do we have to be, like, doing anything right now, or... I legitimately don't remember how to fight this guy! There we go. Apparently bomb arrows are the way to go, as usual. No, damn it. Okay, mortal draw on mini-bosses is not a practical thing to do, because mini-bosses are open, or bosses in this game aren't open for that long. Like, you pretty much have to attack them right away, so using an attack that makes it so you actually have to wait to even do anything is not a good idea. There we go. You have to kind of lead your shot a little bit with that guy. Okay, thank God. Am I crazy, or did that guy not even attack me once? Cool design, but maybe a little bit lame on the actual threat department. I mean, I am at 2 hearts, so maybe I shouldn't be taunting him. Okay. And now we can grab our reward. We had to jump down this pit. Spikes just come up immediately, killing Link. Like, that was the boss's ploy all along. Anyway, for defeating whatever the hell that thing was, we get the spinner. Yeah, you so far we've gotten Zelda staples like the claw shot, the arrows, the slingshot and stuff, and no, now we get the spinner. Hands down the strangest addition to the item pool of this series, and a pretty cool one. So, the gimmick of the spinner is it does exactly as the name implies, which is, if we put it on one of our buttons, we'll just put on R, we can actually use it to spin! It's Beyblade! So yeah, using the spinner we can actually ride the walls in these little divots, and yeah. You can also ride around like this, and Link looks like a total dweeb doing this, but it's somehow really dumb looking and really cool at the same time. I don't know how they did it, but they did it. Okay, let's use this baby to get farther. Okay, now that we actually have the spinner, the camera is freaking out again. The game did this before in another dungeon. I forget where. I think the camera gets like stuck on a pot or something, and then it just freaks out. Anyway, do not do that, Link. I need you to actually ride this wall. There we go. Using the spinner, we can ride walls like this, and we can actually traverse the dungeon very easily. One added benefit that the spinner also has is that it can, well, first off, it isn't actually affected by quicksand at all, so it can just ride along the sand like that, and, Link, you're an idiot. There we go. Unfortunately, the spinner does lose momentum very quickly, so, yeah, we fell off, unfortunately. So we're gonna have to get back to that room and try again. Wonderful. It's not like there's an army of bugs coming my way or something. Oh god! Okay, that was really bad. If I landed in the quicksand and actually, like, voided out, I think I would have actually died, because... Jesus Christ, this is terrifying. I think I actually would have died, because I'm pretty sure, like, falling in a pit does 2 hearts of damage, so, you know, on hero mode, so I think I actually would have died, which would have been extremely bad. Don't bonk, Link. I need you to get through here. There we go. Ugh. Let's try that again. There we go. And jump! There we go. As you can see, you can actually jump off walls too while you're riding, which is really cool. It's such an out there idea for a dungeon item. It's just, I have a feeling like this is one of the first ones they came up with. Oh god, that's actually gonna kill me. Go, 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 Link, go! Oh god! There we go. Wow, bomb arrows like literally just break them. Oh, thank god, I knew it was in this room. I was really hoping that would be the first chest we find. Again, a surprisingly easy piece of heart. You just ride the spinner and you get it. And I don't know, both pieces of heart in this dungeon feel really like, we gotta put the pieces of heart in the dungeon somewhere, so let's just put it here. Because every dungeon in this game, you might have noticed this trend right now already, but every dungeon in this game has two pieces of heart. So, yeah, they just threw them in there, I guess. Get across there. Into this pit. There we go. Oh, God. We've reached maximum speed. This is ridiculous. Look at Link right now. He doesn't know what he's doing. Whee! this dungeon item's dumb. It's fun, but it's dumb at the same time. It's ridiculous. Anyway, oh, there's actually a chest on the ground floor over here. And a Stalfos. Man, he was just stuck down there. He couldn't get past that little lip in the ground, so all we had to do was just aim a single bomb arrow and take him out. Poor guy. I don't know what I expected. Well, I was hoping for rupees, maybe, because we do actually need rupees soon, but who cares about that? We gotta get Meaver stamps. Hooray! Ugh, more death gauntlets. Never would have guessed. In the Death Gauntlet Desert Temple. Oh, God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I was so excited for a second. I was like, did I break the game? Can I just run to the exit? No, unfortunately not. Yeah, let's try this again. Son of a bitch! There we go. That's a really weird cycle that you have to hit to get across there. And I, like, collided with one of them, too, when I did that, so... Oh, hey, the dungeon key. Sweet. That's actually the end of the dungeon then, sweet. Man, the timing of everything in this dungeon was strange. It was like, you get the compass and the dungeon map like immediately, and you get the dungeon item and the big key like 5 minutes before reaching the boss. Like you usually find it at the halfway point, isn't that weird? Anyway, like I just said, we actually have the spinner and we have the dungeon key, so now we can actually use this item. And Link can do whatever the hell Link's doing right now, and we can actually open up this wall and reach the boss. Simple as that. Dungeon's surprisingly straightforward, especially once you grab the pose. It's pretty much just a sprint to the finish. And by a sprint, I mean a wall climb. And by wall climb, I mean wall spin. Wee. I'm having a wonderful time. That's not good. It's actually too far. There we go! As if Link landed that. And now Link will do his happy squats. I wish they came up with a better animation for this, because it looks super dumb. It's ridiculous. This item's just plain ridiculous. Okay, straight to the top we go. It's also ridiculous how much speed you get off of it. Like, it does not look natural at all. Okay, can we actually get a fairy or something? That would be appreciated. There's no fairies or anything. There's nothing. Okay, whatever. Let's just do it then. We've gotten through the dungeon with measly hearts, so sure, let's just go to the dungeon with no backup. Go to the dungeon boss with no backup whatsoever. Why the hell not?